Hey guys, coming to you from out here by the pond again. And Jordan's been working on a little invention here for the last couple days, and he'd like to show it to you and show you how good it works. And like I said before, we tend to, neighbor kid or two shows up every time we get something out that's fun or dangerous. And this might be both. I'll let Jordan explain to you what we got going on here, how this works.
I used 2-inch pipe for an air chamber that goes into a ball valve that shoots pretty well anything that fits in the 3/4-inch barrel.
Okay.
I used a bolt-in valve stem off of agricultural tires.
Okay.
For that, just so the air would fit in better and right, not leak through, because we had a problem with that.
Mm-hmm.
And then I mounted 3 tactical rails on the gun in different places.
There's one up here, one on the side, and one on top. Okay.
And I put a red dot sight, just aim through, even though it's not working right now.
Okay.
And a FAMAS, I think, hand grip that I cut up.
Okay.
To make it fit better.
And then you also made this so the whole stock thing can come off, correct?
Yeah, this whole thing, the whole main body of it slides off if you cut the zip ties.
Okay.
All of it slides
off. That way you can modify it or whatever you need to do, make repairs. Or
what it fires are these.
Yeah, this is, people, this is a very heavy piece of metal. That's an expansion bolt and with a couple of nuts and a washer on it. And I mean, you're talking something that weighs substantially more than like a 50 caliber shell or something like that. So we're talking quite of an impact when we fire this. This particular gun, it's made out of PVC that's rated to 280 PSI. And we're only pumping it up to about 75 PSI right now because we want to have a margin of safety. And also we found with our air guns in the past that it really doesn't need to have all that extreme of pressure. It's more about the volume to the barrel ratio, basically. And Jordan, hold on just a second here, Jordan. Jordan is going to try to, we dragged this toilet out of the woods, and he's going to try to hit her dead center right there in the tank, hopefully. And we'll get it on tape, and we'll see what kind of damage this thing can cause. I'm going to look over his shoulder as he hits it, try to get her lined up real good. And we'll look over his shoulder. Woo! Okay. Let's see what kind of damage we got. Let's see here. Oh, and you'll see that it, in fact, went clean through this porcelain. And I want you to see how thick, if you can look at that, look how thick that porcelain is. And that heavy piece of metal, here, I'll show you something here. Watch. Clean hole through there, and with just a little bit of tug here, I'm sure this whole piece here would just come out, because it went through it clean, like no problem. And so I would say that was pretty effective, huh, Jordan? You happy with the result there?
You need to make something bigger so it explodes it.
Okay. but anyway, we're still working out the details on the projectiles to put in there. But what he came up with seemed to work pretty well. That was another thing, just to be safe, he built them just a little bit loose so they're not super tight into the barrel. And that does cost you some velocity, but we don't have to be as concerned about it hanging up in the barrel and that kind of stuff. Which with a compressed air gun, you can control the pressure, so it's actually a little safer than an explosive gun, like a typical potato gun with hairspray or something. And but I was kind of proud of his little invention here. And in the days ahead, we're going to find some cooler stuff to shoot, like televisions, microwaves, all that kind of good stuff. And we'll get out here and see what kind of damage it does, and we'll get to see the progress that Jordan makes with his ammo and everything. So anyway, Ethan, what'd you think of that? Pretty cool.
That was awesome.
Okay. And here's one last look at it real quick so you guys can kind of see the design. And we'll be getting out of here. One quick thing I probably should say, you know, if you're a kid out there watching this, Jordan's 14. He designed it himself, but the only thing I did oversee when he glued it with the PVC glue and everything, because you're talking about some dangerous chemicals there with the primers and the glues. And also you want to make sure that it's glued effectively so that it's safe and you don't have it bust loose on you when you're pressurizing it. And also your parents should always be involved with any kind of weapon, because that thing, as you can see, puts out quite a bit
basically
of power.
A gun.
I mean, you basically, it's a gun homemade out of PVC.
Oh. And to show them how hard it did hit, it hit on the back end, and there's the brace that holds the and then back.
It actually altered the expansion bolt from hitting it, and so that gives you some idea of the impact. And like I said, that's a heavy, heavy projectile hitting into something, so if you were to measure that impact, it would be pretty severe. But anyway, I thought you guys might find it interesting. And like I said, days ahead, we'll find some cool stuff to shoot and we'll film it and show it to you. So see you later. Bye.